Welcome back, students. We are resuming with our last topic or the last video of this video series on super finishing processes. So in this particular video, we are going to study in detail about the process which is called as powder coating process. Generally, powder coating process is widely used for painting the products. Powder painting, you must have observed it. So many of the parts are powder painted nowadays, so in which a fog of powder paint is produced and the parts are cured in this particular fog of the powdered paint, and the layer is deposited on the surface. So this same method we are using for obtaining a great surface finish or even distribution of powder is ensured while performing this operation. That's why this process we are studying under the super finishing process. So this is part 4 and final part of this video. So let us see in detail what are the various process, what are the various methods by which we can perform this particular process. So powder coating by far the youngest of the surface finishing technique in common use today. It was first used in Australia about in 1967. The powder coating is a technique of applying dry paint to a part. The final cured coating is the same as two-pack when paint. Two-pack when paint means the two layers of the painting that can be observed when we are performing the powder coating operation. In normal wet painting such as a house paint, the solid are in the suspension in a liquid carrier, which is must evaporate before the solid paint coating is produced. Okay, so basically paint is a solid state object. So in order to produce that paint, we are generally doing what? We are having certain type of wet liquid substrate in which the paint is dissolved, and we are applying that substrate onto the surface, and then we are allowing it to dry for some time. But on the contrary, in powder coating, the powdered paint is applied to the part. The part is then placed in an oven and the powder particles melt and coalesce to form a continuous film. Okay. So now there are two main types of powder that are available to the surface finisher. First is called as the thermoplastic powder, which will remelt when heated. So these powders are nothing but they are applied onto the surface, and if I want to remove it or obtain certain good amount of adherence to the work surface, then they are can be remelted also. So those powders are called as the first type, which is called as the thermoplastic powder, and thermosetting powder, which I will not remelt upon reheating. So during the curing process, a chemical cross-linking reaction is triggered at the curing temperature, and it is then the in this chemical reaction which gives the powder coating any of its desirable properties. So the basis of any good coating preparation, the vast majority of the powder coating failures can be traced to a lack of suitable preparation. So what is crucial thing here in powder coating operation? The preparation for the surface as well as preparation of the powder. The preparation treatment is different for different materials. Now this is very important point. Whether we want to perform the powder coating operation or mined steel or cast iron or copper, so based on that the surface treatment will be different. Okay, then let us see what is the process of powder coating. The powder will stay attached to the part as long as some of the electrostatic charge remains onto the powder. So certain type of electrostatic charge is, first of all, that powder is charged with that electrostatic charge, and it is going to stay on the surfaces or cling onto the surfaces as far as this electrostatic charge remains into the powder. To obtain the final solid, though abrasion resistance coating, the powder coated items are placed in an oven and heated to a temperature that range from 160 to 210 degrees centigrade, depending upon which type of powder we are using. So now, under the influence of heat, thermosetting powder goes through the four stages to full cure. So what are these four stages? First of all, it will melt, then it will flow over the surface, then it will get a gel like structure onto the surface, and then it will cure itself. So now the powder particles melt, flow together and fuse to produce a continuous film that will vary from high gloss to flat matte depending on the design of the powder by the supplier. So which design you want or which type of finishing you want, it completely depends upon the design of the powder. During the cure cycle, the chemical cross-linking reaction which gives the thermosetting powders their unique properties takes place. So during this, curing operation is nothing but drying of this powder or setting time of this powder onto the surface. The chemical cross-linking reaction which gives the thermosetting powders their unique properties takes place during this curing process. So this is a schematic diagram for the powder coating process. You can see here, this is the notation for the coating particles. This is the notation for the negatively charged coating particles. So what basically we are doing, a high voltage generator is used to force or spray this, charge this particular powder particles with the negative charge, and then these negatively charged particle will cling onto the surface which is pre-treated, and then we keep this surface in the oven for the curing process and then apply the next layer of the powder. Okay, so you can see here a spray gun which is generally used for performing the powder coating operation. It is given over here. Spray gun funnels mixture of resin, pigments and additives into the electron nozzle. Then electrode nozzle mein kya hota hai? What is the process that we are performing in electrode nozzle? Particles are electrically charged here. Then this electrical charge is what? Negatively electrically charged. These negatively charged particles exit the nozzle electrically charged at the speed towards the product or the material, as this is the positively charged. So these negatively charged particle move towards this product material, and then material is painted with minimal amount of waste. So whatever the powder we are spraying from this gun, it is directly getting cling onto the surface. Whatever is not falling in this zone, only that amount of powder is recollected in a chamber which is recirculated through the nozzle vacuum to the nozzle. Okay, so that's why it is a minimum wastage is occurring while performing this particular operation. So this is the step by step diagram for powder coating process. Clean, first of all clean the surface, then rinse the surface, then this is very important, etch the surface with positively charged etchant, then again rinse the surface, then chromolate or phospholate the surface, then chromolate or phospholate, this is the application of powder, rinse and then denim rinse the surface. So this is the standard process for the aluminium. This process is going to change when we are changing the material to certain other type of material, for example steel or cast iron, etc. Powder coating process for aluminium. So this is discussed in detail over here about this diagram. Oil and grease are removed in weak alkali solution and the surface is etched to remove the heavy oxide. After rinsing, the aluminium is dipped into a chromolate or phospholate solution to form a conversion coating onto the aluminium, and this film is chemically attached to the aluminium. After rinsing, the aluminium is finally rinsed in demineralized water. The conversion coating has two functions. It presents the surface to the powder, which favors adhesion more than the oxide, which for very readily on aluminium surface, and it reduces the incident of underfilm corrosion which may occur at holidays in the coating. So this is the standard floor plan for in which the powder coating is performed. You can see here the raw material aluminium has arrived here through the conveyor. It is fed to the systematic conveyor through the belt conveyor. It is then given to the overhanging curve conveyor. So those parts are hanged over here. Then here the pre-treatment is going on. Then here the powder coating is going on. Here the oven curing, and then packaging and dispatching the materials. So applications of powder coating are: thin powder coatings can be bent, but this is not recommended for exterior application. Bending of the powder coated material bending is not at all desirable. Powder coating can be applied over a wide range of the thickness. Powder coating can be applied to almost any surface, including metal, timber, glass, concrete, rock, McDonald's, burns, etc. All the things can be painted with powder coating operation. If sufficient care is taken, the part will fit into an oven and will not deteriorate at the temperature used to cure the powder. Powder coating has been used instead of wet paint, electroplating, galvanizing and anodizing in such application as white goods or wet paints, decorative knob for plumbing fitting, door furniture, etc., concrete reinforcing rods, fencing and window frames are also powder coated. So these are the application areas which you see powder coating. So you can see here, this is the tethoscope which is having fiber. The ear for this ear scope is made up of fiber, but it is also powder coated in order to get a good surface finish so that no microorganisms will stay on the surface, and it will also creating a good shiny structure to this surface. Okay, then you can see here dividers, rounders, all these things, the galvanized part used for transmission, various automobile part, tractor part, various parts of the turbines, etc., aviation industries, all these things are using what? The powder coated parts. So these are the application areas of the powder coating. So this is all about the surface treatment or the surface improvement methods. These are the references, and thank you very much. This was the last video, so we will end this series of videos with this particular video. Thank you very much, dear students.